Hello and welcome to Club 10, this week with Carlton's Jake Weitering. Good to see you, Jake.
No, likewise, Rob.
How are you feeling?
Yeah, not too bad. It's 15 days post-surgery now, so it's coming along nicely. I guess the initial thing is trying to get range and strength back into it, and then obviously a little bit of contact, so we'll just try and make it as quick as possible on the way in.
So surgery went well?
Yeah, no, surgery was a success for sure. It's always important that you're trying to, avoid any sort of infection and make sure it's all structurally pretty good in there. So the surgeon did a terrific job. The doctors at Carlton also looked after me well. And again, into my rehab now, so the physios are looking after me and try and get back as soon as possible.
We saw those pictures of when you did it. You just seemed resigned to your fate.
Yeah, it was sort of, as I knew immediately when I'd done it. I guess the first question I asked the doc when I got down into the rooms was how long. Wasn't, you know, if it's going to be okay or anything like that, it was how long and when can I get back. So I guess it's frustrating. It's all part of football and guys have injuries. It could have been worse. That's sort of my mentality, and it's a 4 to 6 week injury. So not the worst thing that could have happened.
And there's plenty of you to look forward to at the end of this year, assuming things go well with the team, which they should.
Yeah, for sure. I mean, the boys had a good break over the bye and came in against Essendon raring to go. It was their 150th anniversary, so a big occasion for them and an awesome win for us. It was scrappy, you'd probably say, the victory itself, but I guess we've won in different ways now, and if the boys can continue to have that form sort of until I can make my way back in, then I'll be a happy man.
So what round are you targeting to return?
It's 15 days post now. Typically an AC is, with this sort of surgery, it's 5 to 6 weeks, so I'll be targeting St Kilda's, probably a little bit ambitious that round, but I think West Coast is probably the more realistic option.
And you haven't missed for a while.
Yeah, it's been a while. I think it was mid-2019 the last time I missed, so the back end of 2019, the hub year, 2021 last year, and no significant injuries, touch wood, until now. So I guess I've been one of the lucky ones.
So one we're feeling desperately sorry for is Caleb Marchbank, who after his big return after almost 3 years out, hurt himself again.
Yeah, it's incredibly frustrating for him individually, and it's in the end, it is quite sad, but I know for a fact that surgery went really well, and he'll be back in the club on Saturday, so straight into his rehab, and that's the sort of guy he is, very resilient individual, because you don't come back from 1,000 days of injury rehab, and it's just impressive, to be honest. So the club will be behind him, the boys will be behind him, and he'll make sure he'll try and get back as soon as possible.
And the good thing for him, I suppose, is that he knows he's good enough at the level after all that time off, because he played so well.
Yeah, for sure. I mean, I played with Caleb in my bottom age year at Vic Country, and he had terrific hands. He was an awesome mark. He's a terrific interceptor. He's got an awesome tank as well, the big fella. So he can sort of play a variety of positions for us, and he's integral to what we want to do going forward. So hopefully he gets back as soon as possible.
Now, is Vossie going to get funky? Virtually all the tallbacks that would start are no longer there. So Sam Durden, the mid-season draftee, is getting a game, which is great for him. But yep. It's going to be a tough task for them.
Yeah, for sure. I think it is. It's a cliche answer, but it's a sign of a good club. The depth that we've got at the moment, I was having a few conversations in recent weeks, but I think it was myself, Oscar McDonald and Mitch McGovern that started the season in those key posts, and now we've got Sam Durden coming in for his first game after, I think, you know, he's only been in the club for 10 days. Lewis Young's doing a terrific job for us, and Lockie Plowman as well. So, as I said, sign of good depth, and if we can get some wins, it's a bonus.
Lewis Young's been a great pickup, hasn't he?
Yeah, he certainly has. He's certainly come a long way as well. He's developed himself more on the physical aspect of the game. He's getting quite physical with his opponent and able to come off an intercept and beat whoever he's on. So it's a good test for him over the next 3 or 4 weeks to take that number one forward and do a job on them. So it's good.
And if you get through this next month or so injury hit in one part of the ground, which is normally a real problem for any club, it will be a great sign for you guys, won't it?
Yeah, for sure. I mean, Harry came back against Essendon, which was an awesome in. Mark Pitnett should be back at some point later on in the season. And then we get guys like, it's just the odd injury that occurs with Adam Chera going out and then provides an opportunity for someone to come in. So, I mean, we've got the depth. As you said, it's not ideal when it probably hits one part of the ground, but We got the win on the weekend, so that's all that matters.
And how's the captain feeling ahead of his 150th?
Yeah, I think big Crippy. I think he might have broken his leg when he was a fair bit younger, and he's been an inspirational leader for our club for, I guess, a darker period of the club's history. And we've sort of come out, we see the light at the end of the tunnel now. He is the captain of our club, and he certainly shows it each week. And to an extent, he's sacrificed himself in recent weeks, playing a little bit of ruck and time forward and doing the team role. So credit to him and congratulations to him.
You get a bit nervous when the Rolls Royce is going to the ruck. Do you feel that?
I'd struggle. I know myself. I'm not overly good when I get corky. So to go into the ruck and just do a job for us each week when Tom DeConning or even Jack Silvani needs a sort of a spell, it's been super. So credit to him.
Yeah, and he's doing well there. Like, he's winning free kicks, kicking goals.
Yeah, he was pretty happy with his... I think he had a shot from 10 metres out, didn't he, against the Dons? So, he's still making an impact for our team, and we've got great depth in our midfield. It's probably our strongest part of our team at the moment with Walshy and Chez and Georgie, and Matt Kennedy's another awesome story that's come out of this year. So they're doing a good job for us.
And you've got the premiership reunion of the 81 and 82 sides. Do you get around those lads?
Yeah, it's been a bit hard in recent years. It seems as though there's a lot of reunions when it comes to the 80s and I guess 87, I think 95. So Carlton's won 16 premierships, so there are plenty of reunions. But those guys are typically around the club. We have plenty of functions mostly with those sort of guys. And it is good to see. In recent weeks, actually, I think it was pre-Collingwood, we had Wayne Harms come into the club for the first time in decades, actually set foot in the club. Sticks Kernahan was in there, the big Fev was in there. It's just good to see those guys come into the club and have a conversation with us, and at the same time they're really proud of what we're producing on the field, and that makes us feel good, that gives us confidence to go out and do a job, so it's good to see.
Now for 17, hey?
17 would be very nice at some point.
Well, thanks for joining us and good luck with the recovery.
Cheers, thanks for having me, Rob.